बैक टू माई चैनल मीनाक्षी तोपदृति, दिस इज शशांक एंड वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल। सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ चैप्टर्स ऑफ केमिस्ट्री टू अंडरस्टैंड डीपर एंड वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट्स बेटर, राइट? सो दैट इज वाई दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। In this chapter, we will be discussing about atoms, molecules, and we will be discussing about chemical bonding, matter, and laws of chemical combination. And our next video will, next chapter actually, will be about mole concept, or it is also called as chemical calculations. We will be discussing many numericals also. Okay, so let's go into the topic. So our first today we will be discussing about some basic concepts of chemistry. Today is we will be discussing about atoms and molecules. So before going into that topics, let's see, we have to learn or we have to understand very clearly three questions in this chapter. The three questions we should think of, okay? The first question is, what is chemistry? Yeah, the branch of science concerned with the substances of which the matter is composed and the investigation of their properties and reaction. What does it say? Generally, matter is there around us. What is matter? That will be our next question. Okay, this something around us, this something is made up of something. Okay, this something is made up of something. So this something is made up of something, right? This one, study of this in making some its properties and its what we call and reaction to form new substances. So there is substance around us, there are many substances around us. So these substances are composed of a substance, okay? That will be our third question, okay? That substance will be taking a reaction to form new substances, okay? So this is what actually chemistry is. Its properties, and we discuss about its reactions, okay? So in detail we can say that it is study of matter and its properties. Okay, chemistry is around us. You know, in my shirt I have cotton, yeah, or other fibers. Those are also made up of some synthetic fibers which we learn in chemistry. My lens is refracting the light rays. Okay, this we will learn in all. Also this glass is made up of everything we will be learning in physics and also in chemistry. Okay, even in this marker, its ink, the compounds present in it, the chemistry makes our life possible. So let me give an example. How we breathe oxygen actually, right? We breathe oxygen. Where do we get oxygen from? We get oxygen from plants. So this will be plants. We will get oxygen from plants. So how do plants give us oxygen? From leaves. Okay, what does a leaf contain? Leaf contains a pigment. What is that pigment? The pigment is chlorophyll is a chemical substance. It is composed of magnesium. Okay, so let me make this very interesting. Okay, chlorophyll contains of magnesium, which is again a chemical element. Okay, so this is what is chemistry. Welcome back. So three questions we should think of. In this, we will be in the second question. So one note that notes are available. So in the, now in this video, what we'll be discussing, I will be post that notes in description and also in comment. You can view them. Okay. So what is matter? This is our second question we should think of. What is matter? Matter is something which has mass and occupies space. Which has mass and occupies space. What is mass here? What is mass? Mass is amount of substance. Amount of substance contained in the body is called mass. So, some even say that something which has also volume. Volume is what? The amount of space it occupies in a 3D way. In a 3D way. Okay? So, I keep it on a plane. Okay? This is a plane. I keep this marker on. Okay? I keep this marker on this plane. It has some mass. It has some mass, you know. It has some mass, right? And it is occupying some space. It is occupying some space. So, this is matter. This is matter. Everything around you is matter. Okay? What is matter? Everything around you. Huh? Okay? So, matter is nothing but substances. We have two types of substances, pure substances and impure substances. After question number 3, we will go there. Okay? Okay, so welcome back. Now, our third question to discuss here. What is atom? Or, what is the fundamental particle of matter? Here only we got the answer. The fundamental particle of a matter is called atom. Smallest constituent of ordinary matter that constitutes a chemical element. Okay, so let me give a scenario. Now, as per Dalton, what did he say? He said, you take a piece of bread. You take a piece of bread. You make it into half. You make it into half. And make it again into half. I divide this. I don't fold this. I divide this. I divide this into half. I divide this into half. And then, how will be the scenario? First, I got a complete unit. From where I got its 1 by half. I got its 1 by 4th. And I got its 1 by 6th. And like that, like that, like that. There will be a case where you cannot divide that further before. That one is called matter. It is atom. Where you cannot divide it further. But this was proven wrong. Atom was divided into electrons, protons and neutrons. We will be discussing in subatomic particles. In subatomic particles. For now, this is atom. Okay? This is atom. Now, this is what actually atoms are invisible and indivisible. Let's discuss about Dalton's atomic theory more further. So, next board please. Okay, so welcome back. Now, matter is mainly divided into two types. Pure substances and impure substances or mixtures. Pure substances, what are pure substances? So, let's discuss the definition later. So, just understand, it's something like pure and impure. Okay? Pure substances are again of two types. We have elements and we have compounds. Mixtures are divided into two types. Homogeneous mixtures, heterogeneous mixtures. Now, let's see the concepts behind these. Okay, so welcome back. Now, pure substances are basically of two types. Single substance, elements and compounds actually. So, what actually is a pure substance? Matter is pure and matter is impure. What is that? Matter is pure and matter is impure. What is pure and what is impure? Pure is something where there are single substances on its own. They are single on its own. Okay? That means, what does this statement mean? Doesn't seem meaningful, like? So, they have definite and constant composition. What is composition? Now, let me take, I have three houses. Okay? Let me take six houses. Okay? Six houses. In this house, there are four people. And in each house, as you see, there are four people. Now, let me take here five, here six, here three, here two, here one, here 12, sorry, 8. Okay, so here you see the before scenario and see here. So we have 2, 3, 6, 1, 5, 8. Doesn't seem uniform, right? Yeah, uniform, non-uniform. So when I take the before scenario, in each four houses, let me take any part, any house, or let me take infinite houses, any house, if I take, there are only four people. Let me take like this, I have infinite. If I take any house, they are unequal people. Okay, this is pure substances are uniform, like this four people scenario. Okay, basically pure substances are of two types, elements and compounds. So let's see its definition. Elements, what are elements? Species of atom having same number of proton in their nuclei. Looks a bit complex, right? So atom looks something like this. Okay, you will understand better in further videos. Okay, atom looks like this. This is called nucleus. Okay, this is called nucleus. Nucleus has two types of particles in it. It has protons and it has neutrons. So if I take an element and in that element I have atoms. So each atom has same number of protons. Okay, this is what element is. It is generally a complex definition. Let's see a simple definition. A component or constituent of a whole or one of the parts into which a whole may be resolved. Looks to be complex, but it is very simple. Let me take a castle or a wall. Okay, I have a wall. You can see I have a wall. In this wall I have bricks. Okay, I have bricks. Each brick is same. So a component or of a whole or one of the parts into which a whole may be resolved. So this is the component and this is the element. Okay, element having similar type of bricks. This wall is having everywhere the similar type of bricks. So that is why these are called elements, and thus these are also pure substances. Okay, welcome back. Now let's see what are compounds. Compounds are nothing but, these are also chemical substances, but they are composed of two or more elements. When we come to molecules, what are molecules? I did not say about this, right? Atoms, like group of atoms, two or more atoms combining are called molecules. So this is what compounds and molecules. So we have discussed till now today. So in the next video, we will be discussing about Dalton's atomic theory. Okay, Dalton's atomic theory, and we will see its drawbacks, and we will be learning what are subatomic particles. This will be the three major objectives of the next video. So signing off for today, Shashank.